رينال الترا ساوند، ات از ا بوينت اوف كير الترا ساوند اور بوغس. Before I start my presentation, I would like to acknowledge that most of the figures I used in my presentation, I got help, a very good help from this review article in the Kidney 360. This comprehensive assessment of fluid status by point of care ultrasound. I would like to thank the editors for this wonderful, a very important review article, and I recommend every one of you to search for this review article. It is an open access. It contains everything you need to know a point of care. And also, I would like to tell you that we will do every point of the focus in our training, and I have my ultrasound machine with me, and I hope you will enjoy my lecture. Our objective today is clinical. What is clinical indication for performing the point of care ultrasound approach to performing the POCUS, normal finding and abnormal finding, and what is the clinical impact? As you know, management of complex fluid and electrolyte disorders is central to the practice of nephrologists. It is our daily practice. All of us work in the ICU and in the clinic, and we day by day we are seeing a lot of issues, either fluid overload or dehydration, and sometimes we cannot judge by our clinical senses, a limited sensitivity of physical examination by using the history, clinical exam, stethoscope to determine the fluid status is limited, and sometimes precluding accurate clinical decision. So what is a POCUS? A POCUS is a non-invasive bedside diagnostic tool. For objective evaluation of fluid status, tolerance, and responsibility to the medications that we will give later. Rapid bedside sonographic evaluation can obtain quantitative data on the cardiac function and pericardial effusion, pulmonary congestion, renal sonography, and intrarenal Doppler assessment of the perfusion of the kidney, portal vein Doppler, hepatic vein Doppler, IVC evaluation for the systemic venous congestion. POCUS is a physiological and hemodynamic study, on-spot objective clinical decision supporting tool, clinical examination extension, unique and expanding tool, safe, non-invasive, and low-cost bedside repeatable tool. Of course, we have now this very small machine that can perform POCUS, and even it can broadcast the ultra sonography picture on a portable machine like a phone or a tablet. But also you can use the traditional ultrasound in your assessment. So it doesn't depend on the machine, but it depends on what you want to do. Clinical indication is suspected acute or chronic kidney injury for assessment of the kidney size, echogenicity, pelvic LCL system, and other pathologies related to the kidney, suspected renal colic, colic flank pain radiating to groin with hematuria. We need to rule out the presence of obstruction and the absence of other pathology. So we need to be sure that we don't need urology with us. Nephrotic syndrome to guide the fine needle renal biopsy and for the fluid assessment. How we perform the study, patient preparation. We have no patient preparation in ultrasound performing, and the transducer for renal is from 3 or 3.5 megahertz, 5 sometimes for same patients. Patient position, either supine, posterior oblique, lateral decubitus, or prone for renal biopsy mainly. Anatomy, kidney, as you all know, are retroperitoneal at thoracic 12, lumbar 4. Right kidney is lower than the left kidney. Right kidney is posterior to liver and gallbladder. Left kidney is inferomedial to the spleen, and it is a little bit upward than the right kidney. Adrenal glands are superior, anterior, medial to each kidney. And this figure shows the diagram of the position of the right and left kidney in between the stomach, spleen, and other organs. Right kidney scanning approach, it is either anterior through the A direction or lateral through the B direction or posterior through the C direction. So this is the back of the patient. Liver is the acoustic shadow. So the study is mainly through the liver. We use the liver as acoustic shadow. The left kidney requires posterior approach through the spleen, air-filled bowel sometimes embeds the anterior scanning. We have the long axis and short axis approach. So this one is the, on the left side is the right kidney long axis. And on this position, you can see the kidney just below the liver, surrounded by the liver, upward and to the left. And this is the kidney. And this diagram shows the position of the liver, the kidney, the anterior, the posterior, the superior, and the inferior. And of course, we have a marker on the ultrasound transducer, and also it appears on the ultrasound direction, so you can know where is the direction actually when you are doing the ultrasound. We will do all this on site, and everyone will have the opportunity to do it by himself. Left kidney long axis, this is the diagram of the view, the inferior, the superior, the kidney, and always the kidney is shadowed by the shadow of the rib, so it will not appear complete, right, right, the like kidney, but there is part of the kidney you need to take the, manipulate the transducer to see the left kidney, and also this is the spleen. And the short axis view on the right, for the right kidney, we will have the kidney in cross section and the gallbladder, liver, IVC, aorta on the right side of the kidney. I'm sorry if there is some voice of the celebration is coming. We'll try to handle my mic. I hope this will be more clear. And this the on the on the right, left, and on the back there is a vertebral body. For the left for the left kidney, we will have a cross section of the left kidney, spleen, sometimes part of the liver appear, the left lobe of the liver. Common pitfalls in renal scanning: failure to scan both kidneys if they are high, very high in echogenicity. Sometimes they look like the background. Mistaken prominent or small kidneys, mistaken prominent renal pyramids for hydronephrosis, and this happens a lot. Mistaken prominent pyramids for renal cyst, and confusing normal renal arteries for the ureter. Then we'll go through the lung ultrasound. We have different zones for the lung performing the lung ultrasound. We have either we can use 16 zones, 12 zones, 4 zones. I usually use the 4 zones for the simplicity. So we have the midline zone, the anterior axillary line, and the either the mid axillary or the posterior axillary line. And we can follow even a line, horizontal line below the navel. We can perform the lung ultrasound. So it is a little bit different than the renal. We have different zone to scan the lung, and we have different places to put the transducer. So we need to scan different and multiple places to scan the lung, because the lung is very big in surface area than the kidney. We will not have the lung in one scan zone, but we can split the lung into different zones. What we are expecting to see in the lung? First sign is the bad wing sign. So it is an interpretation, long ultrasound, we have to put on our mind, it is interpretation of artifact rather than visualization of the pulmonary parenchyma, because air is strongly reflective to the ultrasound beam. The normal lung, the only detectable structure is the pleura, which is the upper space here. Pleura appears as hyper echogenic, the bright one, and in the horizontal line in between the ribs. This is one rib with the shadow, another rib with the shadow, in between is the pleura. So it looks like bat wing appearance, or called bat sign. In the normal lung, we have the A lines. They are equidistant, hyper-echoic horizontal lines seen on normal lung ultrasound. Those are the A lines. These are vibration artifacts formed due to multiple reflections of the ultrasound beam between the transducer and the pleura with the underlying air-filled lung. So it is reflective from the pleura. In the exudate or transudate in the interstitium, another vertical hyper echoic artifact are seen. It is termed the B line. It is equivalent of the curly B line seen on chest radiography and to provide a semi quantitative estimate of the amount of extravascular lung volume. So this is very important. In the lung ultrasound, we have in normal, the A lines, as you can see, it is a reflection from the pleura in the air, and the B lines when there is fluid in the alveoli, either exudate or transudate. We can also determine the alveolar consolidation. In the case of alveolar consolidation, the lung parenchyma can be visualized on ultrasound similar to that of liver and spleen. Sometimes you don't know, are you visualizing part of the liver or it is actually a parenchyma of the lung. But with expert hands, you can determine where is the anatomy and where is the position. Also, pleural effusion appears as an anechoic space above the diaphragm and typically surrounded by atelectic or consolidated lung, this part. So lung ultrasound also, it is very important. It provides a dynamic information. The change in B line count can be used to monitor effectiveness of decongestive ultrafiltration therapy and titrate it accordingly. And during your round, when you do a lung ultrasound, you also, especially in ICU intensive care patients, you minimize the transportation of the patient to the radiology facility. And also it gives you a rapid information and accurate information. Also, there is a lot of information new to the radiology also that can be extracted from the lung ultrasound. It is like the B line count that you can monitor your therapy and the effectiveness of your therapy. In a recent randomized controlled trial, including 71 clinically aovolemic end-stage kidney disease patients, those who underwent pre-hemodialysis, lung ultrasound-guided dry weight reduction achieved a greater reduction in weight compared to those receiving standard care, correlating with the change in the number of B lines. Also, patients with acute exacerbation of heart failure, B line count has shown to be consistently decreased with diuretic therapy soon after presentation. So you can monitor your therapy when you give, for example, diuretic therapy, if it is effective as regard removing the congestion or not. In ambulatory patients with chronic heart failure, an 8-zone lung ultrasound-guided diuretic therapy was associated with significant reduction in heart failure-related urgent care visits compared to standard care. Clinical trials are in progress that may provide further insights into long-term outcome of lung ultrasound-guided therapy. So it is very important to perform this. Focus the cardiac assessment is the focus. It is the same, it's like the focus, but it is for the heart. So it is focused the cardiac assessment. We have 5 different cardiac views, standard cardiac views to assess the heart. all of our colleagues doing echo, they are knowing this by heart. We can also assess, see the evaluation of the left and the right ventricular function and the presence or absence of pericardial effusion. We don't need to do a detailed echocardiography for the patient, but it is a hemodynamic assessment by the focus. So for the left ventricular systolic dysfunction, qualitative estimation of eyeballing of the left ventricular ejection fraction is another key component of focus in patient with depressed left ventricular function. Both wall thickening and inward motion are decreased. Hyperdynamic ventricle is indicative of volume depletion in the appropriate clinical context. So you need to know two information. If the heart function is contractility is within normal by the wall motion of the heart, and if there is any pericardial effusion. So this is a relative chamber size, the apical forward chamber, parasternal short axis view, and volume overload giving the appearance of D sign. If you can see here, the left ventricle is forming a D sign. It's very evident due to the restricted interventricular movement and the collapsing of the right ventricle. In the parasternal short axis view, it is coping with volume overload. So by looking for this sign, you can know if the patient is overloaded or not. Because such patients are hypotensive, you may feel that he is shocked, he needs more fluid, but actually empirical administration of intravenous fluid goes further, compromise of the left ventricular cavity and reduced cardiac output, and the patient will go immediately to pulmonary edema. Pericardial effusion, you can see here, there is a rim of pericardial effusion and here moderate effusion. It is an important cause of hypotension as well and the hemodynamic compromise. And also it can affect the kidney. It can be quickly identified on focus. It appears as anechoic space between the two nine pericardial layers. Parasternal long axis and subcostal views allow better visualization of the effusion. Measurement of the separation between the pericardial layers and diastole determines the severity. So if it is less than 1 centimeter, it's considered mild. 1 to 2 centimeter considered moderate, and more than 2 centimeter is considered severe effusion. Assessment of systemic venous congestion, either by looking at the long axis and estimating the collapsibility of the IVC, and the looking to the hepatic vein congestion and portal circulation, and also looking to the kidney perfusion. Central venous pressure, the CVP, is the strongest hemodynamic determinant of the development of worsening renal function in patients with the compensated heart failure. Normal and abnormal patterns of flow in abdominal and central veins result from retrograde transmission of central venous pressure. Focus can enhance the clinical evaluation of venous congestion using venous Doppler in addition to IVC ultrasound. What is the take-home message? Physical examination is limited in determination of fluid status, so focus is not a replacement to clinical judgment, and also it has a susceptible limitation. Augmented examination using focus is a non-invasive bedside tool that provides detailed insight into cardiovascular physiology, lung congestion, renal assessment, systemic venous congestion by abdominal venous Doppler. So combining the clinical examination, laboratory data can guide our management. Further studies are needed to determine whether management guided by abnormalities detected on focus translates to improve clinical outcome. And thank you very much.